Because he is in BTech MTech course, so we'll be answering your queries related to that course. So let's start. He's ready to answer all your queries. Are you ready?
Yes,
sir. So, okay. So the question is, what inspired you to pursue your career in engineering and why did you choose this college?
Engineering? The one obvious reason would be better medical. But except that, since the beginning, I had a sense that I want to somehow contribute to the society. And this is one of the good ways of doing it, so engineering. And this college, like before taking admission, like we had a boot camp here on emerging technologies when I was in the advanced grade. So the amount of curiosity it generated in me, I thought, why not apply for this college? Well, simply I applied and got in. You can secure yourself fortunate to this moment.
So, what's the syllabus actually for this exam? Which exam did you give for this?
I believe most of you might have given JE mains, and yeah, your results would have been out. I'm sure they will be all wonderful. So, there is an exam called NFET, similarly conducted by NTA, which has similar syllabus, like 70 or 80% is your mains. 20 to 30 is aptitude, normal aptitude. Herein, the questions would not be that difficult. The difficulty would be easy to moderate, but you'd have to be more speedy and more accurate. Like, they would get a mark in this one.
So, is it like JE difficult or NFAT difficult?
I would say NFAT is slightly below the difficulty level of JE, but herein, again, as I said, easy questions, but you have limited time. You have 90 minutes for 100 MCQs. So,
and what if like JE percentage is mad, like it is considered in this for university intake?
I would say JE is not at all considered. Firstly, they are considering to take JE advance as a criterion, but now there is NFAT, so I don't think there is any advantage.
Okay, we'll get you, we'll check it out and we'll get you know about that. Now, the very next question is, what's the eligibility criteria which students can pursue in this course?
If you have got 60% in your 12th grade, which I'm sure you might have got, and you are eligible to apply. And if you apply and there is a counseling process of your examination, so if you are called for counseling, congratulations, you got it.
Great. Why did you choose this Gandhinagar campus and not any other campus?
See, firstly, I would say, especially from cybersecurity aspect, the labs are quite good here. And as per our counselor, what they told us, they made a lab for OT security, which is a bit technical, but for that, the Ministry of Home Affairs has spent around 130 crores for a single lab. And it is one of its kind in the Asia, first ISO certified lab. So there are a lot of other facilities which we'll explore if you get the chance to come here.
Guys,
Jaldi,
how are they able to get their juniors as well?
And even if you don't get the chance to, I'd suggest at least visit once. That'll be good for you.
So the next question is, how are the professors and the faculty, like how are the teaching style and...
So all the core faculties are PhD and they are quite good in knowledge in this aspect. So you can go and appear them with your doubts, and there also is a stereotype, the professor hai, itna chudu, so hai, you know. Here there is not that sort of mentality. You can approach them whenever you want to, and in terms of knowledge, it is a bit nice.
True that. Thanks to him, he's doing this in a very humid place. Because Sunday or at college, Monday, then kisi class mein bhi shoot nahi kar pa rahe. So thank you, Punch. So the next question is, how is the college placement record for BTech MTech students?
Well, for that, I will mention it, but I might not sound like a credible source. So those of you who are on LinkedIn, check out, there was this report, placement report, we'll mention the link in the description. So according to that, average 45 to 50 companies visit, out of which are Microsoft, EBB, Adobe, Micron, Reliance, Qualcomm, Salesforce, Amazon, Adani, Mercedes-Benz, Accenture, Infochips, the Big Four. And the stipend offered is 25k to 1.5 lakhs per month. And that is given in the last two semesters of BTech MTech course. Highest package offered was 67 lakhs per annum. Median package offered was 30 lakhs per annum. And the lowest offered was 8.10 lakhs per annum. So you can check that out. I'll put it in the description.
Yeah, I'll put that in the description. You just pass me the link and I'll put that.
So that is a good scope if you are thinking. And it would be way better. Like this was the all the corporate companies. There are other opportunities which are not mentioned. We talk about that in detail.
What actually are the other opportunities?
There are organizations like government organizations.
Okay, government organizations. Talking about. So the next question is, how is the hostel and mess facility for BTech MTech students?
In general, hostel and mess facilities are quite good as compared to other colleges we look at. You might have seen some college tours around on YouTube on your channel as well. So it is quite good comparatively, and the price is quite competitive as well. So yeah, check that out.
Yeah, and mess is the same for every student, for every hostel. So mess is not a question over here. So yeah, how many hostel seats are allotted for your course?
Well, for our course initially there were 5 or 10 seats allotted. So yeah, they are quite limited, but if you got the merit, you'll definitely get it. And there are some new hostels being built as well, so that they might increase it in the future, but I will not be too hopeful for now. So work hard for that merit.
Yeah, work hard, all the best guys who serve and giving this exam. So the next question is, what are your future plans after graduation? And do you have any specialization or something in your course?
We have a specialization in cybersecurity, that is a general computer science and engineering course for bachelor's, and then we have a specialization in cybersecurity. So there are multiple aspects to cybersecurity as well. There is red teaming, blue teaming, SOC analyst, OT analyst. If some of you might know the technicalities, there are multiple, so I am yet figuring that out. But yeah.
Great, yes, a lot of knowledge. I think I don't have any. I don't have anything related to this blue or something. What did you say?
The attacking team, the one that is known as ethical hackers. The blue team is the cybersecurity analysts or professionals.
I found this hacking term very fascinating. I don't know why.
Actually,
yes. And how's your academic workload
overall? Well, your academic workload is not that much in cover the first 2 years, but yeah. It eventually increases, but in the initial phase, you have a lot of time to try new things out. So exploration can be done quite significantly.
Is there any internship or something in your course?
You can externally apply for them, but ideally they are after the fourth year.
Okay.
So when we are in the last year, we have internships.
Okay.
And to add on that, there are multiple workshops, boot camps being organized, like there are 1 to 2 boot camps every month. So you get a lot of industry exposure as well.
Have you been to any boot camp and what are your experiences?
I've been to a lot of them, like recently there was one by AWS, there was one by Microsoft Azure. Before that there were OT analyst boot camps, associate analyst boot camps. There are different boot camps for master students as well. So you get a lot of industry exposure with that as well. For that also you can check out, we'll drop the link in the description.
These were the questions, but the very last one is, can you please share your tips for incoming BTech students?
Well,
how to prepare and all of that.
I would suggest, just stick to your basics, work hard, and don't go for very advanced questions. If you can solve the basic to moderate ones quickly, that will be sufficient, I guess, and you have general knowledge more regarding government organizations as well. And to add on top of that, our school, that is School of Cybersecurity and Digital Forensics, is also organizing such a questionnaire session on 12th of May to get into that, we'll have a link to register, which will be dropped in the description as well.
Yes, for sure. That link will be in the description. So these are like questions related to BTech, MTech or something like cybersecurity?
Questions related to cybersecurity in general, whether you are interested in MTech, BTech.
Okay.
And in the end, I'll be more than excited to see you on this site.
Yeah, great. Even I'll be more than excited too. So that's it for today's video. I have raised all your questions to him and he answered very nicely. Thank you so much, Kunj, for coming here and just doing this part of the video. And thank you so much. Thanks for watching, guys. Anything you want to say?
Yeah. If you still have any questions, you can always reach out to our channel or our email.
Yeah, you can just comment down the questions and I'll be happy to answer that for you. And I'll ask Kunj if, like, he'll answer your questions again. So thank you for watching. If you guys found this video informative, just give it a like, share and subscribe, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye.